Very good morning to one and all present here. Welcome you all again to your class of English. And today we'll discuss about the next part of the story. Till now we have discussed that Horace Danby had reached to the house where he had to burgle the safe. And he was just about to open it, but he was feeling troubled just because of his hay fever and he had allergy from the flowers. So he just tied in a handkerchief on his face, and then a voice came at the back from the doorway, and there was a woman in a red, wearing a red dress, asked him that is it allergy or something else. Now let's read what happens next in the story. The safe was not going to be hard to open. After all, he had lived with locks and safes all his life. The burglar alarm was poorly built, and he just went into the hole to cut its wire. He came back and sneezed loudly as the smell of the flowers came to him again. Then he was thinking that it is a very easy task for him, that he had always to deal with the locks and safes all the time. And in the next, he thinks that how foolish the people that they just give a detailed description of houses in the magazines which carry valuable things. And in one of the magazine about this house at Shootover Grange had been given a complete description of the house, its rooms, and even it has been revealed that the safe was hidden or behind a poor painting. Then he heard a voice say from the doorway, "What is it, a cold or hay fever?" Before he could think, Horace said hay fever and found himself sneezing again. When there was a voice came asking him whether it's a cold or a hay fever, then Horace instantly answered hay fever, and he just sneezed again. The voice went on, "You can cure it with a special treatment, you know, if you find and just what plant gives you the disease. I think you would be better. You would better see a doctor if you are serious about your health. I heard you from the top of the house just now." Then the voice continued coming on, then and advising Horace Danby that you can cure it with the help of a special treatment, and you could refer to the doctor. You can go to the doctor and you even investigate about the plant or the flower which gives you this disease or the allergy. And if she adds that if he is really seriously worried about his health, then I heard you from the top of the house just now. So now let's see next what happens in the story. So the next question is, who is speaking to Horace Danby and who is the real culprit in the story? Now to find out the answers of these questions, let's proceed to the next segment of the story. It was a quiet, kindly voice, but one with firmness in it. A woman was standing in the doorway, and Sherry was rubbing against her. She was young, quite pretty, and was dressed in red. She walked to the fireplace and straightened the ornaments there. As it was a quiet, kindly voice, the woman who was speaking had a very quiet and a kind voice, but she had a firmness in it. As she was the owner of the house and she had no fear here, being here. So the woman was standing at the doorway and the dog, the Sherry, was rubbing against her. She was young and quite pretty and she was wearing a red colored dress. And she straightforwardly walked to the fireplace and just kept her ornaments there. "Down, Sherry," she said. "Anyone would think I would been away for a month." She smiled at Horace and went on, "However, I came back just in a time, though I didn't expect to meet her." Then she said the dog Sherry to sit down, and then she added that the others were thinking that she would be out for 1 month, and she then smiled at Horace and she kept on saying that I just came back in time, but I didn't expect to meet a thief, a burglar at my house at this time. Horace had some hope because she seemed to be amused at meeting him. He might avoid trouble if he treated her the right way. He replied, I didn't expect to meet one of the family. As Horace was hoping that there would be something that is not going to be worsened, because she felt the feeling of happiness at meeting that woman. And if he would treat that woman in a right way, just obey what she says, then he would just avoid the bad circumstances or the worst circumstances. And he also added that he also didn't expect to meet one of the family members. She nodded. I see. What an inconvenience it is for you to meet me. What are you going to do? She nodded. She just moved her neck and asked and replied that I know that it is not a convenience. It is not comfortable for you to see me here. But I just want to ask you that what are you doing here? Horace said, my first thought was to run. Of course you could do that, but I would telephone the police and tell them all about you. They would get you at once. Horace then said that I just really wanted to flee from here. Of course, she said, you can, but then I will call the police, and then in that circumstances, they would definitely catch you, arrest you. Horace said, I would, of course, cut the telephone wires first, and then, he hesitated, a smile on his face, I would make sure that you could do nothing for some time, a few hours would be enough. Then Horace added that the first thing that I did after entering the house to disconnect the wires of the telephone, and then he was hesitating when answering this question, but he wore a smile on his face. Then I know that you would not be able to do something, at least for some time, because it would take hours to get it connected with the telephone wires again. She looked at him seriously. You would hurt me. Then the lady replied that by giving him a grave, serious look, if you would try to flee, you would try to run, in that case, you would hurt me. Horace paused and then said, I think I was trying to frighten you when I said that. Then Horace stopped and said that I also trying to just got her fear. When you didn't frighten me, Horace suggested. It would be nice if you would forget you ever saw me. Let me go. Then Horace advised the woman that it would be nice for her if she allowed him to move and just to forgot and to pretend that she had never seen anything and she had never met Horace Danby. The voice was suddenly sharp. Why should I? You were going to rob me and I will let you go. You will only rob someone else. Society must be protected from men like you. Then she just raised her tone and said in a sharp tone, why should I? Why should I allow you to go? If you would be spared from here, then you would be able to rob someone else. And she added that it would be harmful for society, and society must be protected from such thieves like you. Horace smiled. I am not a man who threatens society. I steal only from those who have a lot of money, and I steal for a very good reason, and I hate the thought of prison. Then Horace smiled and answered that I am not a person who can hurt the society. I just steal only from those who are really rich, and a small amount of money taken from them would make no difference to them. And I just steal for a good reason, as I really want to buy the rare and expensive book, and for that I need to rob a rich house. And moreover, I really hate the thought of going to the prison. She laughed and he begged, thinking that he had persuaded her. Look, I have no right to ask you for anything, but I'm desperate. Let me go, and I promise never to do this kind of thing again. I really mean it. Then the lady in the red dress laughed and he begged, he was just pleading to let him go and thinking that he had just made her agree to allow him to leave. But the lady said, I have no right to ask you for anything, but I'm desperate. But the lady said, I really want to know something. But he was consistently asking her to let him go and promise that he would never do such kind of thing in his future. And he added that he really meant this thing. She was silent, watching him closely. Then she said, "You are really afraid of going to prison, aren't you?" Then the lady remained silent, and she was saying that, "Do you really think that you are really afraid of going to prison, aren't you?" She came over to him, shaking her head. "I have always liked the wrong kind of people." Then the lady just came closer to Horace Denby, and just shaking her head, and she asked that, "I never liked the people like you who commit thief in the others' houses." She picked up a silver box from the table and took a cigarette from it. Horace, eager to please her and seeing that she might help him, took off his gloves and gave her his cigarette lighter. As the lady picked up the silver box kept on the table and took a cigarette, as Horace just wanted to please, just make her happy, he just took off her gloves and offered her his cigarette lighter. "You will let me go?" He held the lighter towards her. By giving her the lighter, he again posed the same question, that would she allow him to go? "Yes, but only if you will do something for me, anything you say." Then the lady put a condition, in only one condition she would allow him to go, and then he eagerly asked about the condition and promised that he would do anything whatever she says. "Before we left for London, I promised my husband to take my jewels to our bank, but I've left them here in the safe. I want to wear them to a party tonight, so I came down to get them." But as the lady made a story or tell him about the incident, that before they left for the London, she promised her husband to just keep all the jewels in the bank, but she forgot to do so, and today she really want to wear these jewels for the party, and so I came down to get them. So that's why she has just came downstairs to get all the jewels. Horace smiled. "You have forgotten the number to open the safe, haven't you?" Then Horace smiled at the lady and asked her that has she forgotten the number of the safe. "Yes," replied the young lady. "Just leave it to me. You will have them within an hour, and I will have to break your safe." Then he assured the lady that she'll get all the jewels kept in the safe within an hour, but for that he just took the permission of the lady to break the safe. "Don't worry about that. My husband won't be here for a month, and I'll have the safe mended by the time." Then the lady assured him that and asked him to move ahead to break the safe, and added that her husband is out of town for 1 month, and within that period of time she would mend the safe again.
Good.
And within an hour, Horace had opened the safe and given her the jewels and gone happy always. For 2 days he kept his promise to the kind young lady. On the morning of the third day, however, he thought of the books he wanted, and he knew he would have to look for another safe. And within an hour, Horace had opened the safe. As he had promised that he would open the safe within 1 hour, he did the same, and he just took out all the jewels and given to the woman of the house. As for 2 days, he kept his promise as he had done to the young lady. But on the morning of the third day, however, the thought of the books he wanted, and he knew he would have the books for another safe, but he never get the chance to begin his plan. By the noon, a policeman had arrested him for the jewel robbery at Shoot of a Grange. He got surprised, and his fingerprints forehead opened the safe without gloves were all over the his fingerprints for he had opened the safe without gloves were all over the room, and no one believed him when he said that the wife of the owner of the house and asked him to open the safe for her. The wife herself, a gray-haired, sharp-tongued woman of 60, said that the story was nonsense. Then the police came to arrest him because of the robbery, as he just depicted or narrated the story that the lady of the house herself, the owner of the house herself, and asked her to take out the jewels, and he did the same just by asking her. But no one believed the story, as because the real owner of the house was a 60-year-old gray-haired woman, and she also herself revealed that the story narrated or told by Horace Denby was just a nonsense. Horace is now the assistant librarian in the prison, and he often thinks of the charming, clever young lady who was in the same profession as he was and was checked him. That Horace was now present was termed for the imprisonment, and he was now the assistant librarian in the prison. And he often thinks about that young charming lady who had just committed the thief and who was a real culprit and who just outwitted Horace Janby. He gets very angry with anyone talks about honor among thieves. And when he in the prison, he just listens other talking about the honor among the thieves. He really got annoyed at this thought. So this is all about the chapter, A Question of Trust. So the author asks a question in the very beginning, that what does this sentence mean, the honor among thieves. So the same sentence reveals Horace Janby when he thought that the lady who was just pretended to be the honor must reveal her true identity at least to a thief, and they could find another way. So that's why Horace Janby got much angry. So my dear students, I am going to share with you an assignment related to this chapter, which will consist questions related to the text. Hopefully you will be able to answer all the questions. Thank you so much.